Dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Professor P. Bhaskar Reddy, Department of Ancient Indian History, Culture and Archaeology, Sri Venkateswara University, Tirupati. In the present module of the paper Museology, we are going to learn about history of museum movement from 1947. In the previous module, we have discussed about the museum movement since its inception and up to the independence and the factors contributed for the progress of the museum movement and also the pioneers and important factors contributed for the growth of the museums. In this module, we can start from 1947, which have a much significance in the history and culture of India, which it resulted for the progress of many institutions in India, particularly due to the development of educational programs and cultural consciousness and growth of several technological, science and industrial activities. It's led to the museum movement in a great progress in India. By the end of this module, you are going to learn the museum movement after 1947, the factors which contributed for the progress of museum movement and the establishment of national museums under the government of India, the growth of science, technology and industrial museums, besides the role of universities in museum movement, the progress of private museums, preservation activity, etc. With these learning objectives, let us start our discussion on what is the progress of the museum movement after 1947. You know that in the year 1947, the India got its independence, but regarding the unity is concerned, the dawn of independence, it paved the way for the dividing of the country into two parts, India and Pakistan. Because of this division, it have much impact on the museum movement. Particularly, besides the cultural properties, the museums which were under the control of government of India was also splitted into two groups. Thus, the consequently rich archaeological sites of the Indus and Peshawar region, as well as several important museums at Dhaka, Lahore, Mohenjo-daro, Peshawar, Rajashahi, Takshashila and several others were went to Pakistan. This was a difficult task, not only to fill up this vacuum, but to vitalize the entire museum movement with a view to present a complete picture of Indian history and culture. Thus, with the dawn of independence and the partition of the country, there was some setback for the growth of the museum movement. However, since then, after the dawn of the independence, several factors contributed for the further growth of the museum movement that we can discuss now. What factors led to the progress of museum movement in India after 1947? In the closing years of the pre-independent days and two decades that immediately followed, the museum movement escalated to a new height. There are several factors which it paved the way for the phenomenal growth of museums since 1947 up to the present day. Firstly, the sweeping contemporary museum movement had a far-reaching influence not only on the mind and thought of intellectuals, historians and art consigners, but also both the central and state governments took a keen interest in promotion of educational activities, preservation of the cultural properties, and as a result, several museums were established under the control of the central, state and other private agencies. Secondly, a variety of museums, archaeological, anthropological, industrial, science and technology museums sprang up and provided a firm footing for museums in the country from 1947 onwards. Before going to the other details, now the Archaeological Survey of India, which already since its inception from 1861, it was the main institution which promoted the museum movement and also they established several site museums. Even before the independence and after the dawn of independence, the Archaeological Survey of India played a similar role in conducting explorations and also to bring several artifacts of our cultural heritage which was hidden in the earth, and there was a further progress even after independence in establishing Archaeological Survey of India. In this regard, we have to consider the services of Mortimer Wheeler, who was the last Director General of ASI appointed in 1944. His acceptance of Markham Hargreaves' recommendation of bringing all the museums under a united administrative belt resulted in creating a special branch for museums in the year 1946 itself. It was the beginning for the further growth of the museums. That credit goes to Mortimer Wheeler. As a committed Director General, Mortimer Wheeler reorganized archaeological circles and museums and trained its officers in modern methods. Thus, the museum movement under the Archaeological Survey of India reached further growth after independence. Consequently, many museums were established in several parts of India, particularly Madras, Amaravati, Hampi, Bodh Gaya, Nagarjunakonda, Halibed. All are the important museums which were established during this phase after independence. Among the several archaeological museums established in post-independent era, the latest of the museum is the Tipu's Relics at Srirangapatnam, which is not only a good collection of various objects related to Tipu Sultan, and the museum building itself is a beautiful one of in architectural point of view. Thus, Archaeological Survey of India contributed further for the progress of the museum movement even after the 1947. As a result, the several state governments also established the archaeological museums under their control. It is known that since the beginning, archaeological museums are more. Besides the archaeological museums, art museums also enjoyed a prominent place in the museum movement in India in the post-independent era. Among the many museums of art, the prominent art galleries are the National Gallery of Modern Art, established in New Delhi, which it is devoted to the contemporary art of India. Another one, the art gallery, Trivandrum, it possesses an excellent collection of Indian and European miniature paintings. We have to quote another example, the art gallery, Mysore, which it has a collection of modern Indian paintings. Likewise, the National Art Gallery, Madras, we have to consider as an example. Besides that, in promoting the art activities, several state Lalita Kala academies, which contributed for the progress of the art, culture and other things. Besides the above, there were several changes occurred in the museum movement because of the establishment of several institutions which promoted the museum movement in India. Among that, Museum Association of India is the one which it established in the year 1944 itself. But its activities were in great progress after independence. The Museum Association of India played a tremendous role, particularly in museographic services, since its inception. The association, it is known that it is a registered society having countries, well-known museologists, historians, conservators, anthropologists, archaeologists, the curators, research scholars, and also several museum activities. Thus, with the mobilization of several personalities of museum activities, it leads to the development of not only the association of museums, it provided the museum profession in general with a forum for the exchange of their views, news and ideas, which it contributed for the development of museums in the post-independence era in India. Besides, in its annual discussions, they discussed and deliberated on specific topics, which they enabled to highlight the nagging problems and suggestions for their solution. They also established a Journal of Museum Association of India, which it also filled a large lacuna for the benefit of the museum professional. Besides the Museum Association of India, there was a organization which established at international level, that is the International Council of Museums, ICOM. What is ICOM and when it was established, what was the role of the ICOM in providing its services for the progress of the museum professional, now we can discuss. At the international level, it is known that many changes were taking place after the Second World War, because Second World War provided lot of ravages for the entire universe to protect that objects or ravages for the preservation and protection. As a result, for various reasons, UNESCO came into existence with its headquarters in Paris in the year 1946. This UNESCO constituted the International Council of Museums, ICOM, in the same year 1946 with the headquarters at Paris. This council has a unique network of more than 35,000 members and museum professionals who represent the global museum community, which it was a landmark in the history of museum movement, not only in India, but also it is a turning point in the history of museology and museum activities at international level. In its General Assembly, which it is a decision making organ that meets every year, this General Assembly sets the functioning rules and adopts ICOM's strategic plan every 3 years at the General Conference, which held for particular purpose to discuss and deliberate all the activities related to museum professionals. With the establishment of this institution ICOM, the museum movement has witnessed unparalleled growth in all parts of the universe. Besides that, another important institution which contributed for the progress of the museum movement is the Central Advisory Board of Museums, known as CABM. It is known that CABM was established by the Minister of Education, Government of India, in 1956, which it was established for surveying the progress of the museums in India and professional help in many ways. Thus, with the establishment of the CABM, it played an important role not only for seeing the museum activities, but it provided funds for the construction of museum buildings, for the improvement of exhibitions and also storage capacities, and also the publication of the museum research and educational activities to the public. Thus, all these factors, Archaeological Survey of India, ICOM, Museum Association of India, CABM, all these were the important factors which that leads to the promotion of museum movement in India in the post-independence. Among the museums which were established in the post-independent era, it is known that the National Museums occupies prime importance. Now, we may shift our discussion to know about the various types of museums which were established in the post-independent. Regarding the National Museums are concerned, the concept of the National Museums emerged and gained momentum from 1947 onwards. The leaders who contributed for the independence movement and who served for the cause of nation, after independence, the leaders started searching for a museum that would enshrine the free country's vast heritage and give her a national identity. In this, it is an important thought for establishment of national museums. Particularly, the National Museum Delhi was established in the year 1949. The National Museum New Delhi began with an exhibition of Indian art consisting of variety of art specimens from various museums of India, sponsored by the Royal Academy London with the cooperation of the Government of India and Britain. This exhibition was on display in the galleries of Burling House, London, in the years 1947 and 48. After the completion of that exhibition, objects were returned to India. On its return to India, the government was decided, and with the decision of the Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, they decided to display the same collection under a single roof in Delhi. Accordingly, the exhibition was held in the state rooms of the Rashtrapati Bhavan, New Delhi in the year 1949, which this exhibition was a great success and it turned out to be a further progress of the establishment of the National Museum at Delhi. On the 15th August 1949, after the completion of 2 years of our independence, the National Museum was inaugurated by the then Governor General of India, Sri Sri Rajagopalachari. Thus, the first National Museum was established in India in 1949. Since then, several museums were established. Particularly, the main aim of the for the establishment of National Museum is the objects of archaeology and arts of the India were housed, besides the objects of other countries was also represented here. That was the main motto for the establishment of National Museum, which it paved the way not only to represent our culture and also to represent the cultures of other countries also. This was indeed an event of great significance in the history of museums in India. The foundation of the present museum building was laid by the then Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru on 12th May 1955. The museum was thrown to public on 18th December 1960. With this inspiration and with the support extended by the government and also interested by the then political leaders and also educational conveners, several national museums were established in different parts of the India, which devoted to special subjects of our not only the education and also with the development of several science and technologies. Several national museums were established with the dealing of several themes. Regarding the national museums are concerned, another important landmark is the Salar Jung Museum. The Salar Jung Museum, Hyderabad, originally it was a museum established before independence, in which it has a large collection of objects of art, not only belongs to India, and the objects which were collected by the Asaf Jahis, particularly Salar Jung, from the various countries of the world. The Salar Jung Museum was taken over by the government of India from them in the year 1958. Later, it was also declared as a museum of national importance by an act of parliament in the year 1961. Since then, it was also became as a pride national museum of India. It is a particularly art museum, international in character, which the objects collected from different parts of the world, nearly 48,000 art objects collected by a single man, Nawab Yusuf Ali Khan, popularly known as Salar Jung the Third. Have a look at the beautiful collections of the Salar Jung Museum. There are several museums that were established in the post-independence era that we can discuss in the later course of time in several topics. Since then, there was a vibrant museum movement across the country. Variety of museums were established under the aegis of central and state governments, universities, public and private sectors, all came forward to establish the museums under their jurisdiction. Besides that, in the subject matters as concerned, there have been grown several kinds of museums in the post-independence, particularly in the branches or subjects of archaeology, history, art, natural science, science, technology, industrial, maritime, textiles, rail, post, army, etc. And various branches of knowledge have come forward and various institutions came forward to establish the museums of their particular subject. Among that, we have to consider the growth of science and technology and industrial museums, because in the post-independence era, there was a overwhelming progress in the achievements of science, technology and industrial. The last 70 years have been significantly for the growth of several museums devoted to that particular field in India. Today, in India has around 1500 museums of national and regional importance with different themes. Owing to the rapid growth of the technology and industry, the latest types which have been developed recently are the pure and applied sciences, technology and industrial museums. In this connection, we have to mention that there is no science museum in India till 1954, when the Birla Technological Institute set up a science museum at Pilani in Rajasthan state. To monitor and support the scientific and technological development, the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research set up first science museum, namely Birla Industrial and Technological Museum at Calcutta in the year 1956. Later on, they set up science and technology museums at Bangalore, Bombay and Patna. One point we have to mention here that India is very rich in natural wealth, but the natural objects are available particularly in the form of geographical, botanical, zoological and various aspects. But these objects, up to the beginning of independence, it was a part and parcel of the big museums of India. Later on, the natural history collection, which formed only sections of large general museums until 1972, from that point onwards, independent national museums of natural history, known as NMNH, began under the Department of Science and Technology, New Delhi. With the establishment of National Museum of Natural History, this inspiration paved the way for the establishment of several natural history science museums in different parts of the Indian regions. Among that, the Southern Museum located at Mysore, Central Region Museum located at Bombay, Eastern Region Museum located at Bhubaneswar, Western Region at Savai Madhopur, Northeastern Region was established at Gangtok. Thus, with the establishment of this type of national museums of natural history, it paved the way for the establishment of several natural history museums dealing with several branches of botany, zoology and several others. This was another important point which we have to mention, which it paved the way for the progress of the museums devoted to natural sciences with independent establishments. All these museums, the science and technology museums, are now under the National Council of Science Museums, constituted by the Ministry of Human Resource Development in the year 1978. All these museums were under the overall supervision and the control of a director general. Have a look at the office of the National Council of Museum, which it is the prime institution of science council, which it devoted and provides the funds for the development of science and also establishment of the science museums and managing of the all science museums. The National Council of Science Museums is the unique organization operating in science and technology landscape of the country and engaged in developing scientific temper in the society through its fast growing nationwide network of science centers, interactive and engaged science activities. As a result, the National Council of Science Museum established 48 science museums, science centers, science cities, and even two centers were established outside India so far. All these developments that took place in the post-independent era, in the promotion of with the promotion of science and technology, science and it made a great progress in the history of museum movement in the contemporary India. Besides the archaeological, the national museums and also science and technology museums, which devoted to specific areas, there are several museums which were established dealing with other branches of knowledge also. Particularly, we have to consider it as the other museums. Regarding the growth of other museums are concerned, the museums devoted to specific subjects have been developed to carry out their educational programs in different fields of human knowledge also. Among the different fields, we have to consider, we have to specially mention Craft Museum, New Delhi, which have a good collection of various crafts of Indian and industries. Then the Health Museum, which devoted to the health, it was also established at Hyderabad with a collection of various branches of the medicine and health activities. The Calico Textile Museum, it was one of the important museum which was established in the post-independent era, which all the textile varieties of produced by the Ahmedabad Milk Corporation, they were established at Hyderabad. Then the Museum of Man, which was established at Bhopal, it has a good collection of habits, living standards and various traditional cultures of our country, which were housed in a one roof in the form of open exhibitions. Then with the progress of rail and transport communications, Rail Transport Museum was also established at Delhi, which it provides the information about the progress of the railways since the inception up to this period. Then the Postal Museum is another type of museum which was established in the post-independent era at Delhi, which it has a good collection of various postal matters and its history. Even the Forest Museum was established at Dehradun, which have a good collection of timber, silvi and also the products of forest and others. It was an important institution which was established at Dehradun to train the forest officers also. Then the Navy, it is an important one. The Navy, the collections and their equipments were also housed at Delhi as an Army Museum. Thus, to quote many, these are only the few type of other museums which we discussed, which all these things says that the museums not only confined to history, archaeology and science, and even almost all subjects of our knowledge and of our living standards form a theme for the establishment of the museums, and it was the main contribution for the progress of the museums in the post-independent era. Besides the above, the post-independence era witnessed the establishment of personalia museums. You know that though it is a part and parcel of the history, the collections of a particular person of national importance from his beginning to his end and his objects and his involvement in various activities, it also formed an important theme in establishing the personal. These were the latest trend in the history of the museum movement in the post-independent era. Among the personality museums which were established in the post-independent era, we have to specially mention the Victoria Memorial Museum, Calcutta, Rabindranath Tagore Museum, Shantiniketan, Gandhi Smarak Sangrahalaya, New Delhi, Nehru Memorial at Tinmurti Bhavan, New Delhi, St. George Fort Museum, Madras. Likewise, several museums were established to show the pride of our national leaders and to carry the message of the contribution of that leaders to the future generations. One more important development that took place in the post museum movement in India is concerned. Not only this time, even with the establishment of the universities also played an important role in the promotion of museum movement in post-independent era. So, what are the institutions of universities which promoted the museum movement? Now, we have to quote. In the post-independence era, to train the museological methods, the universities of Baroda, Calcutta, Varanasi and Technological Institute at Pilani introduced 2-year post-graduation course in museology, particularly for the promotion of professional purposes. Besides these universities, the Aligarh Muslim University and Birla Museum at Bhopal, they also came forward to introduce diploma courses. Besides the above, with the establishment of the UGC, in the recent years, the UGC too has come forth with liberal grants for the development of museums of the teaching departments of the universities, as well as full-fledged multi-purpose university museums. We have to mention the best examples of this category which were established in the under the control of the universities are Bharat Kala Bhavan, Varanasi, Ashutosh Museum of Indian Art, Calcutta. Besides the government and several agencies of the government, even during the post-Shatavahana period, the private museums were also established equally for the preservation and promotion of our heritage and culture, and also private museums were also have a good collection of the art objects. Thus, besides the government and several other allied institutions, the private museums also contributed for the progress of museum movement in the contemporary period. In the last 5 decades, the museums have become an intrinsic part of India's urban life. As a result, the museums, mainly private initiatives, were constructed across the country. Here, the main objective was to display, preserve, and document the rich cultural heritage of India on par with the government and national interest. Among the important private museums which was established during the post-Shatavahana period, we can quote the examples of this category are Udaipur's City Palace Museum, set up in 1969 by Maharana Bhagwat Singh of Mewar, which it was one of the important museum. Guru Sadai Dutt Museum, Calcutta. Raja Dinkar Kelkar Museum, Pune. Vechar Utensils Museum, Ahmedabad. Sulabh International Museum of Textiles, New Delhi. Kiran Nadar Museum of Art. Likewise, several private institutions also came forward in establishing the museums, and they have a collection of multi themes dealing with almost all activities of the past. Even we have to quote the toilet museum, that is a good collection of various toilets which was used by the India in as a part of our civilization. When this type of progress is going on, keeping in mind the changing dimensions of the postmodern museums, the Museum Association of India is keen about adopting a few heritage sites and developing them as museums. Thus, the Museum Association of India also, not only they provided professional services and other things, they also came forward to establish the museums, which it boosted the museum movement in the post-independent era. Besides that, one important point which we have to mention here, the preservation activity. With the establishment of several museums of national and regional importance dealing with the various subjects, they have a good collection of objects devoted to their subject, which it reaches to lakhs and lakhs, which it is essential to them for the preservation and protection of their objects. As a result, as a part of the museum movement, the preservation activity also is an important one, which it also helped for the museum movement in post-independent era. Preservation, you know that to protect the objects which were collected by the museums in safe and in for the forever. As a result, the government of India in the post-independent era began strengthening the conservation activities by enriching the laboratory of the National Museum, New Delhi. Later in the year 1971, it was formally recognized as an authorized center for the training of conservation professionals in the country. Further, the government of India set up in 1976 an independent national research laboratory for the conservation of cultural property, research and training. This was another landmark in the history of museum movement in the post-independent era. Thus, the museum movement, which suffered some setback in the year 1947 due to the dawn of independence and due to the partition of country into two, but we saw a rapid progress of museum movement, and all these things contributed for the progress of museum movement in India up to present day, which there are nearly more than 1500 museums of national and state importance were located dealing with various branches of learning. Coming to the summary is concerned about this topic, museum movement in India from its birth owes a lot to the hard work of visionary individuals, both Indian and foreigners. It exhibited all round growth, particularly after independence, which we have discussed earlier. The museums of various types covering almost all aspects of human knowledge have come up with an idea to preserve our cultural heritage. As a result of the interaction of all the factors discussed above, museums in India are much better placed than ever before. In this regard, a consideration of the development of museum from one stage to stage would itself provide an index of the rationale of the phenomenal achievement. Thus, we have covered the history of the museum movement from the inception up to present day in two topics. In these two phases, the governments are different. In the first phase, the British government. In the second phase, India after establishment, it was under the control of. And in both the phases, we saw the several stages of museum movement, which it helps not only to understand the history of the museum movement, and also various stages and various factors that contributed for the progress of museums. Nowadays, the museums are the institutions of not only the cultures, not only the centers of cultures, enjoyment and others, they are the centers to carry the message of our cultural heritage from one place to present day. Thank you.